Well, hello, people of the Earth. Today we're going to try to understand reactors. Some of you already know about them, and those who don't know, React is changing. Well, it has changed already. If you're looking at this video in December of 2018, hooks are already here. You know, they're in alpha right now, but it will be become more popular. And React wants you to use hooks more and more. Because it replaces classes. You can still use classes with hooks, but it doesn't make sense, right? So because if you use hooks and not classes, then you have to do things hooks way, which means the lifecycle hooks that you used to use, you have to do a different way. If you're using Redux, you have to do a different way. Pretty much everything else that you used to use, like pure component, everything you have to do different way. What I might do is create this as a series, and this might be the first video in the series. I haven't decided yet, but I'll provide a playlist at the end. If there's a playlist, then I have created a series. And by the way, don't forget to click on that bell sign on my channel so you get the notification when I release a new videos. Just a reminder. And welcome to Texas Tutorials. All right, so the question is, how do we use this React hooks? So I've created this project using Create React App. And in order to use React hooks, you need to have version of React 16.7 and later. But when I created this project, the version wasn't out, but there was an alpha version out. So I'm using alpha version, but if you're using later time and if this version is available, you should be able to use it, right? So what I did, I created a project using Create React App, and then I changed the React version to 16.7.0-alpha.2 and then install the package, okay? And make sure that you use the right version of Node. I believe it's 9.10.1. All right, so that's out of the way. Let's understand what the hooks really are. So as I said, hooks are here to replace the class components and other things also. But the main thing is, I guess React team figured out that classes are cumbersome, it's hard to manage for them internally. So they needed a little simpler way. I'm not gonna go too into it, but basically, when you create a container, you would usually use a class component, and then for all the other presentational components, you would use a functional components, right? Here, with hooks, everything is functional components. There are no class components, okay? So like your app here is a class app extends component, that goes away. You need class components right now for if you define state, you have to use class components. But with hooks, that is changed. So you use hooks to manage the state and you can use functional components. So let's do that. So what I'm going to do is this part, I'm just going to comment out for a second. Then I'm going to create a function. Remember, as I said, you can use this app, which is a container, I can make it a function, right? So I can say export default, and I can use an arrow function here, okay? I don't need to give it a name, right? Because it's only one component, so I can make it an export default, okay? And then I will uncomment this, copy this from here, well, up to here, return. So there is no render method anymore, right? It's a functional component, so you can, and I'm just gonna delete the class part of it, okay? I also don't need component here, so I'm gonna delete that, okay, and save it. And let's just test it to see if it works. All right, so it works. I have some test here. Okay, so now, let's introduce state in here and how it works, right? So for that, we're gonna use two things. We're gonna have a person and its name and age, and which will be basically nothing but state, and we can increment the age and we can change the name So we'll have an input box and a button, right? So let's create a name first. Where I'll have some name. I can have input. Okay. This will be type equal to text. Then I have another paragraph with age. And then I can have some button, which allows me to change the increment age by one, something like that. All right, so I have this name, age, and when I click on it, it will increment the age. When I type in here, it will change the name. Okay, so how do we get the state now? How do we define the state? So there is no state variable. And since it's not a class component, we cannot use state directly. So we need to use hook for that. So that's why the hooks comes in the picture. So here we have a special hook called useState. So we need to import this from React. And after that, since there is no class, there's no this.state, everything becomes variable. Okay, so we can have a variable const age. Okay, but instead of having a variable, we will have to have an array where the first element is the variable age, and the second variable should be a function called set age. So this will allow us to modify the age. So this is the age variable, and this is the function that will allow us to modify the age. Borrow this from this hook, set state. And then we can pass a default value. Let's put it 21. So I want to make this person 21 when by default. Similarly, let's say for name, we can do the same thing. We can say name, and you have to have a setter, set name. So this set age and set name is almost like set state that we used to use, right? But now we have to, for every variable, we have to do this way. Then we would say set state, and let's call him Peter or something, okay? So this is his default value. All right, now for the age, we can interpolate here, name. Remember, there's no this.name anymore. We can simply use the name directly. And here I can use value equal to, my bar, not set state, it's supposed to be use state. We're so used to use the set state that we forget. Okay, so now I have the name. I cannot change it right now because I don't have an onChange event. And, well, age, I have not name, this should be age. All right, so I have both now. Now let's write onChange event, which will change the name, and we can have onClick event will change the age, right? So let's build first onClick event. On click equal to, and we can just directly have inline event. So when I click on it, this button, it should change the age by one, right? Increment the age by one. So as I said, we have this set age, right? Which is like a set state. So all we have to do is set age. And then I can take the age plus one, right? Very simple. Take the current state, which is age, and then add one to it. Okay. Now let's see, if I click on here, it works. As for the name, I can add, well, let's just format this nicely. I can add on change event, which is similar. So for on change event, we have an event handler, and we can say set name, which allows, which for if I want to change the name, I have to use set name, right? What name would it be? So whatever I'm typing in, which comes from the event, right? Event dot target dot value. So now if I change here, whatever, it would add it. So to see it, let's just add the whole object here, right? So I'll add another paragraph at the bottom. State is age is nothing but age, and is nothing but name. So right now age is 21, name is Peter. Let's change it to John. And now it's changing here. And if I click on here, it's a little bit odd if you start using it in the beginning, because it takes a while to get your brain gets adapted to this. But once you start using it, it's pretty neat actually. Now you must be wondering, okay, what about the life cycle events? And since what if I want to use a pure component or a lot of other things, right? Like everything will have to be done differently. There are hooks for all this stuff, Redux, right? If I want to use Redux, I have to do it differently. And there are hooks for that as well. I would say learn step by step. First, use one hook, and you can actually create your own hooks, custom hooks as well. We'll cover that later in this series. Now, there are some pure rules that you have to follow when we use hooks. For example, this state variables you have to define in the top. You cannot put in conditional. You cannot say if this, then use this. You know, you cannot do that. At the time when I created this video, it's still in alpha, so there might be some bugs, so don't be surprised. If you want to use this in a production version, I would say wait until they have a good release, which actually it's stable, okay? Don't just go in and change all the production codes to definitely explore it, okay? And what I'll do is I'll put this the code on my GitHub site, and I'll provide a link in the description so you can check it out. And I hope you learned something from this video. And if you did, please like. Don't forget to like, subscribe, and provide a nice comment. And you can also support this channel via Patreon. You know how hard I work to make these videos. It takes a lot of time. So I appreciate your support. And also, you can follow me on Facebook and all the other social media. I'll provide the links. And if you want to help me out differently, you can translate this video for me to your native language if it's not English, so your countrymen can also learn. And thank you.